Since superconducting magnets are in the news at the moment, I wanted to tell you about how they are vital to the research we are doing in particle physics here at CERN. If you're new to my channel, then hi, my name is Clara, and I am a particle physicist who makes videos about physics to share the wonderful world of science with you. This blue tube behind me is a prototype of the LHC dipole magnets, and we have 1,232 of these 100 meters underground for the LHC. These dipole magnets generate a field of 8.3 Tesla, which is 100,000 times stronger than the Earth's magnetic field. To do this, we need 160 superconducting cables. Each cable has 36 strands, and each strand has 6,500 superconducting filaments made of niobium titanium. The length of all of these filaments, if we put them end to end, would reach from the Earth to the Sun and back again 9 times. And we put around 12 kiloamps through these cables. So to be able to maintain their superconducting properties, they have to be cooled to very low temperatures. And we're talking 1.9 Kelvin, which is 1.9 degrees centigrade above absolute zero, the coldest temperature ever possible. And we cool them with superfluid helium, which is one of the reasons that the magnets are so big, because we have to isolate the room temperature on the outside of the magnets from the very, very cold temperatures at their core so that we don't lose the superconducting properties. So if it was possible to have room temperature superconductors, this would be incredibly exciting because we wouldn't have to mess around with all that cooling. We could just create these high magnetic fields without the superfluid helium, which does create some challenges for us when we're running these magnets. But as Carl Sagan said, extraordinary claims require extraordinary evidence. Personally, I am skeptical about recent results that have come out, but I do remain optimistic that one day, possibly, we could have room temperature superconductors, and it would also have applications, not just for particle physics, but also for medical technology, potentially also for travel and many other uses as well. So let's see and keep watching.